Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mazhar Ali and I welcome you back to course Introduction to Computers. Today we are going to discuss online business in the online world. It's a very significant topic, especially in current days. So online business, commonly called the e-business, is any kind of business or commercial transaction that includes sharing information across the internet. Commerce constitutes the exchange of products and services between businesses, groups, and individuals, and can be seen as one of the essential activities of any business. So electronic commerce or e-commerce focuses on the use of ICT to enable the external activities and relationships of the business with individuals, groups, and other businesses, while e-business refers to business with the help of the internet. So e-business differs from the electronic commerce or e-commerce as it does not only deal with the online transactions of selling and buying of products and service, but also enables to conduct business process as well, and means the business process within the value chain through internal or external networks. So the term e-business was coined by the IBM's marketing and internet team in 1996. E-business can take place between a very large number of market participants. So it can be between business and consumers, private individuals, public administration, or any other organization such as NGOs or so on. So transformation toward e-business is complete, so there is a need to balance between strategy and adapted business model, right processes and technology. And technology means the supply chain management or the customer relationship management. And the business model may be the intermediary or the marketplace. So when organizations go online, they have to decide which e-business model must suit their goals. So a business model is may be defined as the organization of product, service, and information flows, and the source of revenues and benefits for suppliers and customers. The concept of e-business model is the same, but used in the online presence. Online shopping is a form of electronic commerce or e-commerce, which allows consumers to directly buy goods or services from a seller over the internet using a web browser. So consumers find a product of interest by visiting the website of the retailer directly or by searching among alternative vendors using a shopping search engines, which displays the same products availability and pricing at different e-retailers. So a typical online store enables the customer to browse the firm's range of product and services, view photos or images of the products along with information about the product specification, features, and prices. So online stores usually enable shoppers to use search features to find specific models, brands, or items. In the online, customers must have access to the internet and a valid method of payment in order to complete a transaction such as the credit card or a service such as the PayPal or Google Pay, Amazon Pay, and so on. So for physical products, for example, the paperback books or classes, the e-trailer ships the products to the customer. For digital products, such as the digital audio files of songs or software, the e-trailer usually sends the files to the customers or consumers or the internet. So the largest of these online retailing corporations are like the Alibaba, Daraz in Pakistan, and Amazon, and eBay, and so on. So yeah, online shopping is become a trend nowadays. and people are going to purchase the items online through the websites which are presented by those companies who conduct the online business. So online businesses are also called the business to consumer, like the mostly the B2C. So business to consumer basically refers to the transactions conducted directly between the company and consumers, who are the end users of its products or services. In the business to consumer as a business model differs significantly from the business to business model, which refers to commerce between two or more businesses. So B2C sales are the traditional retail model where business sales to individuals, but business is conducted online as opposed to in physical stores. So the features of the this model may be the searchable catalog. These are all the business organizations offer the online catalog, so customers search the those catalogs. And there is a secure checkout. When you select the product and you final your shopping and checkout, it's a really secure checkout. Means which products you have selected, those are only for you. No one can take to their cart. So it provides you secure checkout, as well as there is a customer support page as well. So if you are facing any problem during the shopping, the customer support page or support team helps you online. Means the team is available for the help of customers. So they help the customers in different ways if the customer is facing the difficulty during the online shopping. There are basically two models. One is a physical model of the business that is in form of shopping malls, business shops, or ordinary shops or organizations and so on. The second model is online stores or online shopping. So we differentiate both. The traditional model is called brick and mortar. So brick and mortar basically refers to the physical presence of an organization or business in building or other structure. Means there are the physical shape of that business. There is a shop, the building, means there is a physical building structure for the business model, business shops or organization and so on. The term brick and mortar business is often used to refer to company that processes or leases retail shops, factory production facilities or warehouses for its operations. Where the e-commerce operations don't necessarily include a physically storefront, particularly when they begin. So instead, these digital natives sell products online through a website and a virtual shopping cart. As you see, when you are going online to shop any item, you will be provided virtual cart to take the products, to put your products in that cart. And orders are entered remotely and the goods are then mailed or shipped to the customers. So you may be anywhere in at any place. Not only, it is not necessary that you should be in cities, but you should be in villages, you should be in remote areas. You may shop online through the online shopping malls or online shopping stores. So brick and mortar businesses, by contrast, have a physical location. As I told you already, that they have the physical shop, physical buildings, and physical structures. They might consist of a single outlet or chain of stores. So for example, there are several shopping or the businesses who have several outlets, Gulayama, Junaid, Jamshed, and several others. They have outlets all over the country and even in the out of the country. However, more and more brick and mortar businesses are adopting e-commerce platform, merging the two to create a seamless shopping experience for their targeted audience. So e-commerce outfits also accept cards, but they don't have a way to take payment by cash or check as the brick and mortar businesses are taking. Even the they take the cash against the sale of their products. But e-commerce or online business cannot take cash as the traditional business organizations or shops are taking. But most brick and mortar outlets accept only cash, credit cards, or checks as a legal means for the purchase of their goods and services. Thus, there's a payment flexibility on both sides when you compare brick and mortar versus e-commerce. But the option differ due to structural capabilities of each approach. However, in the brick and mortar properties, there's a limit of the time, means there's a time of shop opening and shop closing. Whereas in the online stores, there's no time limit. You may shop any time, means 24/7, you may shop. And in the mortar, brick and mortar, sales people can offer assistance to you. When you are entering in shops, they will offer you the assistance, and no doubt in the online shopping, you may be assisted by the online support team. So customers can handle the merchandise in the brick and mortar physically, whereas in the online, they may see from the different dimension, means the 3D dimensional photos may show the products or merchandises. So online stores, as I told you, these stores are open 24/7, and no doubt sales people usually not available physically, however virtually the sales assistants or support team is available. So this is the major difference between the brick and mortar and the online stores. And this is the example. This is a brick and mortar store. You see, the customer discusses about the product with the sales assistant. That means she's available physically in the shop. In the physical shop. However, in the online stores, you may go through their websites and check the product from different dimensions, and you may get help from the supported team, but not that like this customer is taking help from the sales assistant. So this is a different between two type of the businesses. An online product catalog is an important cornerstone for e-commerce retailers. By selecting a complete e-commerce platform, you will have access to ready-made templates and online tools, especially designed to help you create and maintain a product catalog for your online retail business. So the catalog provides you different types of the products from multiple dimensions, the detail of that products, the manufacturing date and expiry dates, and the warranty and usage, as well as the internal and external view of the products. So those catalogs are very colorful. So the good online stores have a catalog, but mostly the online stores have a catalog that present their products, and products are often arranged by category wise, means what type of the if you are purchasing any product, you have to go to the category of that product. Means it will make you ease that you may not bother for in finding the different categories because products, because products are not mixed and gathered, they are kept category wise. So that's a very good way of online shopping stores that facilitate the customers in finding a proper product which is required to him or her. And products can be found by keyword as well. If you are not going to catalog, you may just search the product or write the keyword in the search bar of that online shopping website, and you will be provided those products. A large number of the products will be there that you may and it depend on you that what is your choice and what type of the product you are going to purchase. But it is a facility that is given you by the online shopping stores. When making payments or purchases online, many consumers prefer to pay by credit card or with the debit card as well. However, there is always some risk when you are making purchases online, so that your payment information could be accessed by thieves or hackers and used to make unauthorized payments. So while credit cards tend to be the safest option, there are several other alternate payment methods that are safe, efficient, and easy to use. However, you should take sufficient precautions during the online payment. The alternate method of online payment include third-party payment services such as PayPal, Amazon Pay, Google Pay, or Apple Pay, bank transfer, transfers, electronic checks, and EFT. EFT stands for electronic funds transfer, that is the electronic transfer of money from one bank to one bank account to another bank, either within a single financial institution or across multiple institutions via computer-based systems with the direct intervention of bank staff. So that is also a way of payment. Means you may pay online using the EFT. So customer service may be any service that helps customers solve problems, such as a service is usually connected to a business or a brand which sells products and offers support. So there are different types of online customer services depending on the type of industry involved, business organization, and the business organizations establish a customer support center to provide online services to customers as well. So the customer support is a range of customer services to assist customers in making cost effective and correct use of a product. And then it includes assistance in planning, installation, training, troubleshooting, maintenance, upgrading, and disposal of the products. So these are the basically which I told you, these are the ways by which you pay to the shop, online shopping store, and get the products. And vendor accepts several, these all type of the payment methods, as I told you. So even you may create an account with the shopping online shopping organization or online shop. Means you generate an account there and submit some money and you shop easily. And it simplifies the shipping as well. If you have an account with the organization, you will not bother in way of the paying. So your amount will automatically be detected, and you shop several items as well, and shipping will be easy as well. So companies or the online stores encourages the customers for this type of the account, and they encourage customers to repeat their shoppings time to time. Even then, if we talk about the customer services, we discussed before in the slides. So these services basically resolve the customer problems. what type of the problems customer facing, the support team solve the problems of customer, that customer maybe the loyal to that company or that shop or that organization. But customers should understand the policies before ordering or shopping any product, that what are the products policies or the purchase and purchase policies, even the sale policies of the organization. So both side means the customer as well as the company should understand the policies before selling or ordering. And there is a very clear contact information available on the website, that how you contact the vendor and so on. The mostly companies fix their return policies as well, and they write instructions along with the product information. Some companies facilitate customer for the return of the product, and some products are not returnable, therefore companies excuse to not return the product once you have purchased. So these all things are available on their websites. And shipping policies as well. Some companies ship your product freely, and some companies take some money or the charges and fees. So these all things are in their services. So if any customer who want to shop online, they may, he or she may get the services from the concerned company. Online banking, also known as the internet banking, and nowadays it is also called the mobile banking, is a basically electronic payment system that enables customers of a bank or other financial institution to conduct a range of financial transactions through the financial institution's website. So the online business or the online banking system will typically connect to be a part of the a core banking system operated by a bank, and is in contrast to branch banking, which was the traditional way, means the traditional way customers accessed banking services. So some banks operate as a direct bank or a virtual bank, where they rely completely on internet banking. Internet banking software provides personal and corporate banking services, offering features such as viewing account balances, obtaining statements, checking recent transactions, and transforming money between accounts and making payments for different things. Even if you are going to purchase any product, you may pay online through the online banking. So a bank teller, most teller services handled online. So a bank teller is an employee of a bank who details, who deals directly with the customers. So in some places, this employee is known as a cashier or a customer representative as well. So most teller jobs require experience with the handling cash and in the university degree or the diploma. So most banks provide on the job training as well to train the bank tellers. So tellers are considered as a front line in the banking businesses because they are typically the first people customer sees at bank. So most teller services handled online nowadays by the online banking as well. So if you are facing any problem in transferring the money or checking balance or another thing, you may contact the helpline at 24/7 and get help from the online banking as well. Even you may balances can be obtained, bills can be paid. Access is typically very secure in the online banking nowadays. Nowadays, security softwares provide you complete security, so no one can hack or temper your account if you are not not opening your secrets to others. Your account will be safe. The business to business model is basically a situation where one business makes commercial transactions with another. So this typically occurs when a business is sourcing material for its production process for output, for example, for any manufacturer or purchasing and so on. So another example, providing raw material to the other company and that will produce output, or food manufacturer or food maker purchase the salt from other company. So a business needs the services of another business for operational reasons. As for example, a food manufacturer employing an accountancy firm to audit their finances. And another way is a business resells goods and services produced by others. For example, a retailer buying the end product from the any manufacturer and so on. So business to business, or commonly called the B2B model, focuses on providing products from one business to another, while many businesses in this niche are service providers. So you will find software companies, office furniture, and the supply in the supply companies, document hosting companies, and numerous other e-commerce business model under this heading. So in the business to business model, business transaction between companies are performed. A business transaction is an event that must be measurable in terms of money and that essentially impacts the financial position of the business. So there are multiple business transactions, like the financial transaction, which they include sales, purchase, reserves, and payments. So all financial transactions that occur have an effect on at least two accounts, depending on the type of the transaction. Mostly in the business transaction, more common transactions are the reorder inventory and purchase stocks, credit checks, and other financial transactions, which I told you. For the online business or the business organization, the network connectivity is significant. So network may be the intranet and the extranet. An intranet is a computer network for sharing information, collaboration tools, operational systems, and other computing services within an organization, usually to be to the exclusion of access by outsiders. So the term is used in contrast to public networks such as the internet, but uses most of the same technology based on the internet protocol suit. While an intranet is sometimes contrasted to an extranet, while an intranet is generally restricted to employees of any organization, extranets may also be accessed by customers, suppliers, or other approved parties. So extranets extend a private network onto the internet with a special provision for authentication, authorization, and accounting. So an extranet is a controlled private network that allows access to partner, vendors, and suppliers, or an authorized set of customers. For example, the employees of an organization who are connected through a network within an organization, it is called the intranet. But other people who are connected with the organization, that may be the business partners, that may be the vendors, that may be the contractors, that may be students, faculty, any type of the organizations was connected with the outsiders. So when outsiders will be connected with the organization through network, that network will be called the extranet. So extranet for external people and intranet for the internal or the employees of the organization. This is a major difference between the intranet and extranets. So business partners must work together, and business partners are using the extranets. And the intranet uses the internet technologies. Only internal workers or the employees of the organization can access the resources of the organization or and use a standard browser to access resources. So all the organizations who are corporate organizations are using the intranets and extranets. Another term is the telecommuters. Telecommuting is a work arrangement in which employees do not commute or travel to a central place of work through any transportation. How such as in office building, warehouse, or store. So teleworkers in the 21st century often use mobile telecommunication technology such as a Wi-Fi equipped laptop or tablet computers or smartphones or other mobile devices to work from home or other places. So telecommuter is someone who works at home and communicates with his or her office by phone, email, or internet. So these employees working outside of the office, they don't need to come to the office, but they may work from their homes or other places through telephones and other internet connections. So these employees are connected to the office through internet or communication technology. So several technologies are used to connect the telecommuters to the office. So like the home computer, I told you, desktop computer, laptop computer, mobile phones, and so on. It is not necessary that you may work from the home, but you may work, if you look here, she's working from a coffee shop. So employees may work from coffee shop, from other places, parks, and so on. The purpose of the organization to work for the organization and to fulfill the job assignments which are given to them. So those jobs have to be fulfilled, job assignments to be fulfilled by the employees. However, the connection of the telecommuters to the organization is secure. Means the key card, they have the cards and passwords, and encryption is used to protect the data. Means all data is encrypted, and all the login of these employees is through the emails and passwords, which are no doubt the unique as well. And the security. Security is a very important part of online businesses. Online shopping. So security means the safety as well as the measures taken to be safe or protected. So often this word is used in compounds such as security measures, a security check, or security guard. However, the web security is also known as web security is different than the traditional security, and it is also known as a cyber security. So it means protecting a website or web application or online shopping application or online shopping website by detecting, preventing, and responding to cyber threats. So websites and web applications are just as prone to security breaches as physical homes, stores, and government locations. So there are several tools to secure the online websites or online businesses. For example, use strong passwords. Strong passwords are vital to good online security. Means when you make your password, it should not be the simal, but it should be strong by using the alphanumerical and symbolic characters. Alphanumerical symbolic characters means there should be the alphabet, both type of the alphabet, capital and simal in your password. The numerical means there should be the number in your password. The symbolic, there should be the symbols in your password. So it should be minimum of 8 characters. And definitely when you will make 8 character password with the combination of the alphanumerical and symbolic characters, it will be safe and great as well. Moreover, you may there are control axes, so your organization or you may put up a firewall. A firewall may be the software based or and the hardware based. So it depends on the level of your organization. If you are running only the single shop, then you should use the software firewall. But if your organization is big, then you should purchase a hardware firewall. The Cisco firewalls are very good. Definitely, you may use the security softwares, antivirus softwares, which control the malicious input and the hackers and other other people who may be dangerous for your company or organization. So update programs and systems regularly. Means if you have installed softwares for viruses and intruders and hackers, so you must update those softwares regularly and monitor for the intrusion, that who is coming in your system. You must check always who is coming in your system. If you feel that is unknown, you must block that intruder. Even you may restart your system. What happened when you restart your system? All the intruders or the hackers are going away, and they have to perform another process again, and to enter in the system is not easy. So once they entered, then they may lose you. So when you see that someone new user or unknown user is entered in your system, you must block that or restart your system. So that will keep your system safe. No doubt now the security software also are very good, but before 1998 the web security was not good and non-existence as well. So all the reputable sites protect their customers, and always when you use your logins, they must be encrypted. Generally secure websites or web pages use encryption and authentication standards to protect the confidentiality of a web transaction. Currently, the most commonly used protocol for web security is the TLS, means the transport layer security. This technology is still commonly referred to as a SSL, and means the secure sockets layer or the PDSL to TLS. So, to assure visitors, their connection should be as secure as well. So one of the most important components of online business is creating a trusted environment where potential customers feel confident in making purchase. So SSL certificates create a foundation of trust by establishing secure connections. So to ensure visitors their connection is secure is basically in benefit of the business organization. SSL certificates have a key pair, a public and a private key. These are two keys for the encryption and the decryption. So these are the keys which are provided by the SSL. When you purchase the SSL certificate, you get two keys. Public key and the private key. So these keys work together to establish an encrypted connection. The certificate also contains of what is called the subject, which is the identity of the certificate's website owner and so on. So these basically secure web pages or SSL allows safe transmission of credit cards or other transactions, that may other business transactions as well. And most of the organizations are using the secured socket where SSL, which I told you already, and secured. They develop the secured pages as well. And even when you purchase the SSL or TSL, your URL is going to be secure. So what is URL? URL is basically a uniform resource locator. This is when you come on the browser's address bar, you will see their URLs in this form. So it's basically a uniform resource locator, generally termed a web address. Mostly people call it a web address. It is a reference to a web resource that specifies its location on a computer network and a mechanism for even the retrieving it. So in this, basically in the URL, there's a different protocols are used. So one is a hypertext transfer protocol, secure, mostly the HTTPS, hypertext transfer transfer protocol. And this is for secure. So commonly people are using HTTP, hypertext transfer protocol. That is not secure. So if you will see websites with HTTPS, you will see a lock there, a green lock there. So that's a lock that shows your URL is secure. So HTTPS is an extension of the hypertext transfer protocol. As I told you, HTTP is basically non-secure, and IS make it secure. So it is just extension of HTTP. It is used for secure communication or computer network, and is widely used on the internet. So in HTTPS, the communication protocol is encrypted using transport layer security, commonly called the TLS, or formally secure socket layer, commonly called the SSL, as we discussed in the previous slide. So the protocol is therefore also referred to as HTTP over TLS or HTTP over SSL. The principal motivation for HTTPS are authentication of the accessed website and protection of the privacy and integrity of the exchange data while in the transit. It protects against main and the middle attacks and the bidirectional encryption of communications between the client and the server. Server protects communication against the eavesdropping and tampering as well. So in practice, this provides a reasonable assurance that one is communicating with the intended website without interference from attackers. The authentication aspect of HTTPS requires a trusted third party to sign server-side digital certificates and so on. So this type of the pages are very secure for the business owner and the customer. Means if the customer is going to pay against the purchased item, the payment process will be secure, and even the business owner may keep their website safe. So these things make the your website safe. So when you are going to start a business or launch any website, you must have the HTTPS. So it's make your URL secure, and you must have the security software to save your products and websites from the hackers and the viruses and other peoples. So thank you very much for watching this lecture on online business in online world. Why online world? Because this world is a digital world. This world is converted into globe. So all spheres or all parts of the world is looking like nearest part, nearest flat or apartment of my building. So when you are online, you are not the local, you are global, and you may access different organizations globally. So ask your questions if you have in the comment box, and write your questions. I will answer you. Share this lecture with your friends that they may be benefited with this lecture, and subscribe this channel that you may get more lectures on this and other topics and get notifications. Don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you very much again.